wherever you are on this most pleasant evening. There has been a clamour to get inside the ground tonight for a much-anticipated game. The roads outside of the stadium have been bumper-to-bumper with traffic. The car parks are full. There is a torrent of humankind making its way from the nearby station, and we expect every seat to be filled. An atmosphere of great expectation. He's had a go! Big moment! Massive goal!
Well, if that was their intention pre-match, let me tell you, it's worked out very nicely. I think for the skipper to chip in with a goal too is a bonus, but this game has already taken on a real attacking edge, and long may that continue.
And a trademark move ends with the inevitable classy finish.
Inter are such an adept counter-attacking team, they produced something out of nothing there. A few seconds was all it took for them to convert a defensive situation into a goal, and it's very impressive.
Inter Milan have an early lead. Good start. Inter Milan will play a certain way here, Jim. What is that way?
Possession is one thing, but when you can move the ball as quickly as they can in tight areas, the game becomes beautiful.
Coutinho sort of run down the left wing.
Pity that, because it had a decent chance of progressing.
Paris Saint-Germain are already trailing here early on. They cannot afford to let this get worse.
Well, it can be very hard to regroup and work your way back into the match, but they've got time.
Going for goal! Missa. That's not going to make it. This is promised. Has a hit! Really well taken goal. Paris Saint-Germain are back on level terms. Well, from right in front of goal, there was no way he was going to miss.
Yeah, I really can't say enough as to how good the final ball was. It took the defence out of the equation for that split moment, and the damage was all done.
Has certainly made things interesting.
Well, what a convincing response to going behind. They've got all the momentum now.
And no, that is pretty much the end of that.
And here's Coutinho. The ball's come loose and the chase is on. Did really well to intervene and dispel the growing danger. Through the first period, and it's looking quite a game here. Missa. Looking for space out wide. No flute, it's what he was there for.
Oh, look, there's only one player who merits all the praise for that. Not only did he finish it,
it's an untidy challenge. Free kick given. Just brushed off the ball there. Gets the better of his man. Is there any support? He might not need it.
Lorenzo Insigne.
More than happy to take the muscular approach. Now surely.
The assistant referee rightly gives him offside.
Out to the right. Now it's Defoe.
He gets past his man.
Well, I'm not quite sure he needed to hold up play quite as much as he did then. A couple of his teammates were very annoyed.
And here's Coutinho.
Oh, super tackle. They were outnumbered and under the cosh. That had to be spot on, and it was.
He's got away. Shapes to shoot!
Oh, the keeper's done ever so well.
Well, what can I say? Truly wonderful goalkeeping.
He's played him through.
That was a good run. The defence looked beaten there.
And the finish!
Always going over the top.
If he sacrifices some power, he may control the elevation.
And here's Coutinho.
Lorenzo Insigne.
Insigne! It's in! They have hauled themselves right back into it. Great reactions in front of goal. He just saw what was on.
Well, for me, that's just pure predatory brilliance. It's not so much the finish, but the way he read the situation when nobody else was even alert to it. It's fantastic.
And there's the end of the first half. Paris Saint-Germain come out of a half that has been quite extraordinary on many counts. High scoring, truly exciting. Neither side able to hold a lead.
It's kind of a hard one to call, Peter, isn't it? I mean, from what we've seen so far, both sides have provided ample evidence that they can add more goals, and I'm sure their respective managers have reminded them that the next one will be pretty crucial. So it's going to be interesting to see how the teams come out for the next period.
What a good half. They've gone blow for blow. And it's 2-2. And just back from your break, we've missed very little of the resumption of the second half.
Paris Saint-Germain playing well with lots of opportunities and plenty positives to take from the first half. Despite this scoreline, converting chances would make a world of difference for them.
And now the breakaway. Gets the better of his man. That's a good ball to find him. Real chance! Goal! Paris Saint-Germain! And they've got their lead back.
Paris Saint-Germain are really pouncing on any straight passes in midfield. We're talking seconds from interception to the back of the net. It's counter-attacking heaven.
He's made it two, and no doubt he's hungry for more. Paris Saint-Germain get themselves into the lead. He's had a lot of chance! And the through ball is intercepted. Whistle's gone, that's a foul. changes here, from both sides in fact. It's a long ball, and it's not hit its target. Insigne, Mesa.
That's what has to be done now, no question about it.
This isn't the time to talk about risks now, Jim, is it? They just have to hurl everything at it and hope for a break.
Spot on, Peter.
Mesa. And here's Defoe. Under. And here's Defoe. It's Defoe! They've scored! Again, we are level. What a contest!
Yeah, looking back at that, that's how you play on the counter. Quick and decisive and ruthless with the finish. I thought it was a stunning, stunning breakaway.
This is quite a battle.
Well, they're back on level terms, so the guessing game goes on. As to what will happen from here, I've no idea.
That intervention was very necessary. Hoists it forward. Under. Lorenzo Insigne. Philippe Coutinho. Can he find a... Has a goal! And it's Messi. He's through the middle. He could be in here. Crowd calling for him to shoot. For goal! Another chance! Goal! Paris Saint-Germain! Into the lead once more! He was so alert to the possibilities there. Great stuff.
Oh, Peter, you can't teach that. You either have it or you don't. His anticipation is on another level to everyone else's. Superb.
Paris Saint-Germain take the lead.
I think the danger for them now is fatigue. I think when the body tires, the mind soon follows. So concentration is key from here.
Philippe Coutinho! In it goes! Inter are back in business! Oh, beautifully dispatched. There was no reaching that.
Now that's what I call finishing. Right in the corner. He knew instinctively who was where and didn't need to waste any time weighing things up. That's a cracking goal.
So, shoots! Strike goes to finish! And another time! It's broken loose!
Paris Saint-Germain are perhaps lacking a little composure when they need it most. Maybe sheer will can come up with the necessary.
And Coutinho! Oh, denied brilliantly!
Philippe Coutinho simply didn't do anything wrong. He was thwarted by brilliance.
And here's Defoe. Under. Defoe. Defoe is fouled. Now, this could be a pivotal moment. Dying minutes, free kick, great position. There aren't many who'd be prepared to wind up a shot from this far out. Insigne! And it's played forward.
They're making life really hard for themselves. The ball needs to be in the mixer, not there.
Going through.
Romagnoli.
Mata goes looking. And now they can launch a counter. Now it's Philippe Coutinho. Lorenzo Insigne goes for goal! And it's Juan Mata. So time is nearly up. One final twist, perhaps. So that's it. It is all over. Terrific match. Universal commitment to attack. All square and rightly. No loser. What are your thoughts on today's game, then, Jim?
Well, neither side could get over the line here. Perhaps one team might be happier.
We'll be right back.
Well, hello and welcome to what amounts to football heaven. It doesn't get a whole lot better than this. The conditions are utopian. The sky is blue and the players are with us for a football match so widely and keenly anticipated. Truly, this is pristine. And the level of expectation and excitement is reflected in the smiling faces of the crowd. They know it means so much, and they also experience between them a great sense of privilege at being able to attend this most special of games.
Old Trafford rising to the occasion as only Old Trafford can. Some terrific scenes at the Stretford end. We have already started here. Jim, you've played in games of this nature. Who can make the difference?
Yeah, Saul. His brilliant technical ability and eye-of-the-needle passing can make a big difference to this team. He's got a wonderful engine too and seems to always get himself involved in the thick of the action at both ends of the pitch.
He would be the obvious choice, wouldn't he? He certainly has all the right qualities. He's through. Chance to shoot. Has a goal!
It's hardly a surprise, is it? That's what we're here for, a player with this wonderful knack of being able to show up and deliver at important times. Yet another example.
Yeah, looking back at that, that's how you play on the counter. Quick and decisive and ruthless with the finish. I thought it was a stunning, stunning breakaway.
Crew ahead. One up to meet it! They've scored! They have hauled themselves right back into it. What a super header, dispatched beautifully.
Yeah, I just thought he wanted that more than anyone else on the pitch, and it was fully deserved. He gave it everything he had.
And that has added a whole new complexion to the game.
Yeah, it's always a dangerous time when you just score. You can easily lose focus and then bang, you're pegged back again.
Chiellini gets into the right position to intercept. Midway through the first period, and it's looking quite a game here. Regardless of the outcome, it is good to see someone running at the defence like that. And he's cut it out. Well intercepted, really well tuned in. Oh, well defended, that had to be done. Get the pass he's looking for. Could move up a gear here. And here's Rashford. Now, can he capitalise? Talisca unable to make it happen for all his good intentions. Good spell of possession this, but very little to show for it. Bonucci, Saul, Rashford, he's got away, and they've been caught out here. Out to the right, looks to dink one in.
Paris Saint-Germain ran themselves into the proverbial cul-de-sac there. Chiellini plays it forward. He's left his man.
Oh, he's got a crucial block in there. Caramo. He's got through. Rashford. That's good defending, very good defending.
Oh, defence got the better of him this time, but I'm sure he'll go again.
Well, the further he went, the more attention he attracted. There was just way too much pressure for him to get the shot away.
There's the whistle for half-time.
So, a very watchable game so far. Action at both ends and the team's level.
Some first-half thoughts?
That was a fantastic 45 minutes of football. I'm really hopeful of more of the same in the second half.
It's been a decent 45 minutes. Competitive, certainly, and a goal each.
So we're into the second 45. And the counter is on. Going through. Shapes to shoot! A collective sigh of relief from the defence.
That's just front foot enforcement. Pressure leads to mistake, leads to chance.
Ramsey drives it forward. Chiellini. Ball's gone out of play. A foul, the referee's given it. Talisca. And here's Rashford. Caramo! And the assistant referee has his flag raised for offside. Can make their change now with a break in play. Saul.
And no, that is pretty much the end of that.
Griezmann.
What a ball this has turned out to.
Has a hit! Goal! Paris Saint-Germain! They've done it! It was coming! They have their reward!
Well, you know, thinking about that, I think they've perfected that on the training ground because it took them seconds to get the ball from back to...
Zaza has a goal!
Really well taken goal!
Well, listen, the writing was on the wall. It looked like this was going to happen, and it has.
What a great finish, but how about the touch? It just allowed him to put the ball exactly where he wanted it, and the rest became a formality.
Well, it's an inspired substitution. Terrific move by the boss.
That's how you make an impact as a sub. You know, when most are tiring, you can impose a freshness and energy to best effect. What an introduction.
This is quite a battle.
Well, there's resilience for you, Peter. As a side, they never lost focus despite the setback. And this is thoroughly merited for me. Now they can go on better, possibly.
Messi tries to get it forward quickly. Dinks one in. And the finish! And he's there to make a great save.
Well, as Tesco Peter, the keeper has just received an A-plus grade.
Ramsey.
Zaza.
Tries a shot! Gets it away! And the game is well and truly turned on its head!
Well, when the game's played like that, it's made to look very simple. You know, I love watching football like this. It's easy, effective, 1-2 and bang. Thanks very much.
Crew take the lead.
No doubt as to who has the momentum here now. The only doubt is how many is coming.
What a delicate ball.
Paris Saint-Germain showing a little more urgency now, and to be honest, Peter, this is what's required.
Yeah. Hope is just about the sum of it, isn't it, Jim?
Well, there's no two ways about it. This is what they have to do.
Ball. Who's going to get there?
And it's Higuain.
Saul. This is in a low one. Shoots! Taken with style. And surely that clinches it. There really is no way back now.
That was a given.
It always was. That's just a great finish, but it's down to very clever movement. You can see this has been obviously worked on the training ground. He knew exactly where he wanted the ball, and it all came good.
It's Zaza!
Talisca.
They've got it back as soon as they gave it away. An untidy challenge, free kick given. Looks to clip it forward. And it's Griezmann. Gets the better of his man. He gets past his man. Chance! Koscielny takes it over to the other flank. Saul. Into the channel. Higuain. Up for the header! Yes! And the lead is three! It is surely done! What a great header. Got plenty on that.
Well, as contact goes, that was tremendous, and it helped him to direct it exactly where he wanted into that net. I think when it comes to the aerial department, this fella is definitely no slouch.
Crew grab a three-goal lead. It's just too easy. And that's that. Paris Saint-Germain have some soul-searching to do here. Having been in apparent control, they have allowed it to slip away.
Your reflections then, Jim?
Well, the surprise for me was seeing a team look so feeble in what is usually a strongly protected area. But the centre of their defence...